Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon. My name is Ifrah Megan and I'm a delegate from Chicago, Illinois. In the next 10 minutes, I'd like to just engage in a conversation with you all. My initiative is about storytelling as a way to find peace in Somalia. Why storytelling? Why Somalia? I'll get a little bit into that detail later, but first I'd like to share my own story. So I was born in East Africa, so you all know your geography. I was born in Mogadishu, the capital of Somalia, and my family flee the war and left to resettle in Egypt, where we lived for 10 years before resettling again in Michigan. Similar to many refugee families around the world, we struggled as we adapted to the culture, learning new languages, and oftentimes with parents and those who left their homes and jobs, just finding a way to survive and to move on. Today, Somalia, as many of you have heard in the news, is known for many things. Now, show of hands, how many of you know about pirates in Somalia? Everyone. I expected that. A show of hands, how many of you know of poets in Somalia? Firyal, the only one. A couple of people, Fadi. This is actually a photo of my uncle, Abdi Galayah, who's a poet in a small town in Somalia called Abudwaq. Because of the war and because of the civil conflict, a lot of people forgot about the voices of the Somali people. They forgot that we came from such a rich culture, such a rich tradition. People focus on the pirates, Black Hawk Down, the famine, which all are important issues that resulted from the political instability in the country. But today, I'd like to urge you all to really hear me say this, that stories matter, people matter, and the world has lacked the voice of Somali people. Somalia today is in desperate need of the voices of her people. I am a Somali American, and my initiative is to put together a book highlighting the different stories of resettlement of Somali refugees around the world. Not because I'm from Somalia, but because I am someone who is, like many of my fellow delegates, is interested in bringing about a change in this world, bringing peace. And coming from a lawless state, growing up in a dictatorship, lived in Egypt for 10 years, and now living in the United States in a democracy, and knowing how much we have here and the privileges that I had to come here, whether as a refugee or, you know, whether as an immigrant, we have privileges. Each one of us have a story, and we have a privilege to be sitting here in this room today. So my initiative is to highlight the voices. How I would go about that is actually something that came to mind based on a project that I collaborated with a nonprofit organization in Chicago about a couple of summers ago. I don't know how many of you are familiar with the Davis Peace Project. So I had the opportunity to receive a peace grant, and I implemented a library and used $10,000 to purchase materials for the library, and then had two different components to the program, one being literacy groups and one being peace workshops. And the idea was to just have a platform where refugees could have, you know, where they could share their stories, where they could be heard. Oftentimes, in resettlement policies, for those of you who are aware of resettlement policies, we resettle refugees from all over the world. We resettle refugees from Iraq, Somalia, Ethiopia, and guess what? One size fits all policies. Where are the stories? Where are these individuals coming from? That's something that I asked myself, coming from that background. And it was so amazing to facilitate the workshops. We met six different times, 6 weeks, and each workshop, we discussed various themes from cultures of peace to the two-state solution in Sudan to Iraqi history. And it was just, this idea for all of us to learn from each other, for the refugees to learn from other participants in the program, for the facilitators and the volunteers to just sit for once and listen to the individuals, tell their stories, not because they have to for a paper or for benefits or for employment, but because it's important for them. It's important to them to claim their history, to claim their stories, and to have a sense of ownership. So how I would like to go about this initiative is that, God willing, inshallah, I hope to collaborate with different organizations around the United States, mainly in the diaspora, so US, Europe, hopefully back in the continent, and really get the stories of resettlement from Somali refugees. Ask them how has the conflict affected them, what they see for Somalia, what they envision for Somalia, and what peace means to them. I feel like we come from a culture that is known in the continent of Africa. We're a homogenous group, and we yet have these, you know, we're suffering a civil conflict. We have different tribes. You know, we shared similar culture, one language, mainly Muslims. Yet, there is an ongoing civil conflict. For the past 2 decades, Somalia has suffered from violence, from the famine that just we all witnessed, from basically things that now every newspaper you read or every magazine, you'll see the headlines, the worst failed state in the world, worst humanitarian crisis in the world. So what my idea of storytelling is because of our rich oral traditions. We're storytellers. We're known to be the nation of poets. I often tell people I'm from the nation of poets, not pirates. And you know, they tell me, oh, really? Yes, really. So what for me, I think that it would be very, it would be an amazing way to bring together the voices of Somali people, to unify our voices through something that's so embedded in our culture, that's so deeply rooted in our traditions. And God willing, with the help of the organizations, the activists in the communities that we have here in the States and abroad, and just a collective effort from all of us to voice our concerns, to voice our opinions, to make sure that the world hears about Somali people. And it's been 15 transitional governments since the war had started. So 15 transitional federal governments and ongoing violence, something must be wrong. And my hope today is to bring forth this idea of we struggled, we continue to struggle, we're lacking the voice of people, so let's hear the people. Let's humanize each story. And that is really a message that I would like for you all to take. How to humanize each story, that it's important for all of us who, whether we're working in the Middle East or Africa or wherever, it's important to really place value to the human story, as we saw and witnessed in the Middle East, the Arab Spring, the people and the voices of people really changed. And I hope to see that in Somalia, and I hope to see that in Sub-Saharan Africa and around the world. So I will end with that, and hopefully you guys have questions for all of us at the end. But thank you very much. Wadmahatsan team.